All right, so what we have here is a snowy scene. I've got a picture here of a house on a snow-ledged hill. And if you'd like to paint along with this picture, what you can do is email me at Micah, M-I-C-A-H, underscore 21, underscore 2000, at yahoo.com, and I will gladly send you a picture of this picture. And you can paint along at home if you like. I have a standard 12 by 12 canvas here, and I have some acrylic paint. And these are some Liquitex colors that I'm using. This is just titanium white, naphthol crimson, yellow oxide, phthalo blue. This is a De La Rowney System 3 acrylic, which is Payne's gray. And then this is a Liquitex burnt sienna, or burnt umber, excuse me. So I'm just going to work with these few colors and see what I can come up with here on the canvas. I've got just some basic brushes here that I'm going to use. Mostly I just kind of work with a few drawing brushes in the beginning. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to start off with my horizon line. Get my paper towel here set up. And so I'm seeing a horizon line that's a little bit higher than halfway here. So I'm going to take like a dirty umber and white color together. And I'm just going to kind of create that horizon line. Then I'm going to come through and still just using some very watery, dirty color. And I'm trying to envision where my angles are here. So the house takes up about halfway. It creates a triangular movement. And I can use my brush to kind of position some angles here of the house if I need to, just to kind of set what's going on. I feel pretty good about it so far. This needs to be a little bit. And I'm just treating it in planes, just trying to get the setup for it. Okay, so already I can see that's not long enough. I'm gonna measure. Okay, so that is the same as that, which is true. And that's the same as that, which is almost true. This needs to come out just a little bit more. And I've got my trees here, and I'm going to try and put those two in. It goes down a little bit lower. There's a ledge here, a ledge here. I'm going to go ahead and switch brushes here. Victim. block out the structure of my house. I'm going to go ahead and start putting these dirty blue colors here. Just to fill in. Okay, before I get too involved with that, I'm going to go ahead and take some of my burnt umber, a little touch of ochre, and I'm going to kind of slather on the side of this house here. That really could go darker. I'm actually going to mix some Payne's Gray in there with it. Here. And now for this little nonsense. And they always do that. Thank you. So right now I'm still just blocking in, which means that I'm just kind of covering all the white. And I'm trying to get a good sense of where the browns lead. They kind of fade as they move up. Turns into like a neutral blue. Make sure I get the sides. Taking a little bit of blue and neutralizing it with the red, the phthalo blue, and neutralizing it with red, and getting kind of a grayed out blue. A little bit too red, so I'll bring a little bit blue back in. And I'm just scanning to see if there's any more of the gray blue. I'm not really seeing it. There's a little bit of that reddish color here. Now I'm going to take my phthalo, mostly, with the blue on it. It's a little bit too strong, so I'm going to take a little bit of that neutral color and pop it down. And by neutral, I just used a little bit of the red, the naphthol crimson, to mix with it. And my main objective, and you can do this any way you want, is I'm just trying to get the canvas covered. So I'm just trying to get as close to the colors as I can without stressing out. And then I'll come back and lighten up as needed. Right now I'm just trying to get an overall, get all the white covered. Once I get all my pixels covered, and by pixels I'm generally talking about the texture of the canvas, and get all that covered. Alright, now that I've got everything covered, I'm going to begin deepening some of this. make my darks darker in the places where that needs to happen. Give myself some secondary coverage. If the layer's too thin, the paint will look kind of incomplete. So I want to get that darker. And when I'm looking here, I'm just going to say, like, what's darker, the tree or the background behind it? And I can kind of use that as a standard of measure. But for right now, I need to get kind of a nice second coat in there. And start to pull some white in to make it kind of snowy and chalky. Alright, now I'm going to take my rectangle brush, my little rectangle, and kind of edge some stuff out. I'm trying to scan for anything that's got kind of that same color that I'm using. And I don't care if this is exact. That would kind of make this whole process go a lot slower. So I'm just gonna get my general sense of it in there. And I'm trying to work areas to let other areas dry. And we can go ahead and pop some snow here. It goes right up to the house. Get some of my blue back in there. And one thing I'm noticing is up here, I'm getting the excess paint off the brush, and I use my finger a lot just so that it's not glopped, so that when I've got the edge here of the brush, it's coated, but it's nice and thin. Then I can turn it sideways, and I can get like a little fine line to scroll all the way down. And then I don't have to be so nervous about, you know, doing the trees. And the thing is that if the line becomes too wider than I want it to be, I can very easily take that off as well. But right now I'm just getting the foundation of some of the trees in there. And then I'll show you how to do that. So this tree is the widest. And then I can kind of measure my distance here and see that this has a little bit more of a guideline there. And the outside of this trunk is a little bit darker with the Payne's gray. Oh my gosh, I gotta cut. I'm so scared. Oh my god, I'm so scared. Oh, that's funny. And I'll go in for some of my yellow ochre and my naphtha, or yellow oxide, my naphtha crimson. And I'm going to put just a little bit of red in here. And I guess in the scope of thing, it's really not a big deal because we're just building up layers anyway. So you can kind of position the layers the way you want to get it started. Roughly, that comes underneath the door of the house. Mm-hmm. Now take a little bit of my ochre, mix with brown, yellow oxide. This window actually has some red in it, I'm noticing. I didn't even see that, and there's some red here too. I think it's very interesting. And there's a little red trash can here. And there's a little bit of red on the roof over here. And then, of course, a little red on the chimney. And actually, I just noticed that there's some green in this as well, which I didn't prepare for. So a little bit of Hooker's green to the mix. Not much, but there's a little sprig of it here. And a little sprig of it over here to the left of the tree. And it's got like some blue and some gray and stuff in it to make it dark. Anchor it down. Anchor some of this down. Put some green in there. Okay, now I'm noticing that behind the house here is a little bit more chalky. I put a glaze on there. Oops. And the glaze is the white with the red and the blue. It's just a little thin, transparent wash. It gives it a little bit of a haze, but also won't totally cover up my tree branches. I'm just noticing that the area behind the house is lighter, so I need to go ahead and pull that out. And then that helps me see things like this that I don't want to see. But this actually needs to come down a little bit more. Now I don't want that to be warmer or wider in the front. So I gotta dirty it back up with a little bit of blue. Sometimes these videos are about what not to do. Score. Do you want to get super bright? Excuse me. Little small tinge of that red in there. Smoke it out a little bit. Too blue. Chain link fence or chicken wire fence or whatever you want to call it is in there. And it's so thin, so much thinner than that even, but let me show you what I'm going to do. Oops. So I can take the brush, clean it, thin it out, and make the whole line thinner. That way there's no pressure to get it just right, you know. I mean, I didn't really feel a lot of pressure getting it just right anyway, but yeah, whatever. I'm going to mix a little of this blue, a little of this brown, a little of this gray, and a little of this white. Brown, gray, blue, gray, white. Heavy proportion on the brown. And I'm going to come in and lighten. Oh, I didn't mean for it to be that blue. And then I'll just marl a little bit of this together. All right, well, I'm done. There's a little cardinal here, but I don't think I want to. I'll paint the little cardinal. I'll paint the little cardinal. We see you, little cardinal. Honestly, I almost didn't see it. Feeling that cardinal, but you're there, and we appreciate you, little cardinal. I'll dirty up your body a little bit. It looks so. All right, so that's my snowy house. I hope that you got something out of that. And again, here's the picture, snowy house. And snowy house. All right, so if you like these videos, you can subscribe, and I will try and print some more for you. And if you have questions, you can email me again at micah_21_2000@yahoo.com and send me your questions, and maybe I'll create a video out of it. Thanks.